Good morning, everyone, and welcome once again to our daily service. Let's begin in prayer. We'll pray together the Lord's Prayer. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. This week we've been looking at Paul's great prayer at the end of Ephesians chapter 3. Before we look at the next little bit though, we're going to read a bit of a psalm together. Psalm 65, this comes from. Praise awaits you, our God, in Zion. To you our vows will be fulfilled. You who answer prayer, to you all people will come. When we were overwhelmed by sins, you forgave our transgressions. Blessed are those you choose and bring near to live in your courts. We are filled with the good things of your house, of your holy temple. Let's pray. Father God, indeed we praise you that you are a God who answers prayer, that confidently we can come to you, knowing our sins are forgiven, and that you have chosen us in Christ. We who were once far away have been brought near. As we think now about the fullness you mean for us to enjoy, please open our eyes, encourage our hearts, and strengthen us to serve you today. For Jesus' sake, amen. Yesterday, we thought about the bit of Paul's prayer where he prays that we might grasp how wide and long and high and deep is the love of Christ and know this love that surpasses knowledge. He wants us to be enthralled, we saw, by the love of the Lord Jesus. Today, we'll see why, the reason he prays this. Verse 19 reads as follows. To know this love that surpasses knowledge, that you may be filled to the measure of all the fullness of God. That's the climax of the prayer, really, the goal to which it's all driving, that we may be filled to the measure of all the fullness of God. That is a huge prayer. Is there anything more we could ask for than that? It's an extraordinary prayer. What could it mean for us to be filled to the measure of all the fullness of God? It would be like trying to pour the Pacific Ocean, the fullness of the Pacific Ocean, into a kid's bucket. Or to put the fullness of the Himalayas into our garden rockery. What could it mean? It means for us to be utterly complete as God is complete, perfect as he is perfect, holy as he is holy. It means to be all that God intends and longs for us to be. It means really to be spiritually mature. But if we thought, well, I'm quite spiritually mature already, this is way beyond where we are now. Actually, Christ is the example that Paul points to of what it means for someone to be filled with the fullness of God. A few verses later, Paul will talk of us becoming mature, attaining to the whole measure of the fullness of Christ. So it really means to become like him. One day, we will be. We will see him as he is, and we shall be like him. transformed perfectly into the image of the Lord Jesus. For now, in different ways, all of us at times will feel empty in this life. But on that day, we will enjoy perfect fullness, filled to the measure of all the fullness of God Himself. So this will be true one day. But for Paul, it's not a nice hope that we might shove in our back pocket till then. It's his earnest prayer that we should grow towards this, that more and more we would know this fullness, more and more we should grow into Christ's likeness. And notice what the key to that is. It's grasping more and more his love for us, knowing this love that surpasses knowledge. We'll never plumb its depths or scale its heights or take in its vast extent. There'll always be more to know, more to experience, more to enjoy for eternity. We will never tire of searching out and marvelling at Christ's love for us. Isn't that wonderful? But Paul wants us to grasp this love more now, so that more and more we might be filled to the measure of all the fullness of God now. He'll go on to say that one way we grow into this is by learning to serve one another more in the church, in love. But here we learn, it's as we make it our earnest prayer. So let's together make this prayer our own. Father, we pray that out of your glorious riches, you may strengthen us with power through your Spirit in our inner being, so that Christ may dwell in our hearts through faith. And we pray that being rooted and established in love, we may have power, together with all the Lord's holy people, to grasp how wide and long and high and deep is the love of Christ, and to know this love that surpasses knowledge, that we may be filled to the measure of all the fullness of God. We ask this in Jesus' name. Amen. Let's join together in a final prayer. Almighty and everlasting God, you are always more ready to hear than we are to pray, and you constantly give more than we desire or deserve. Pour down upon us the abundance of your mercy, by forgiving us those things of which our consciences are afraid, and by giving us those good things for which we're not worthy to ask, except through the merits and mediation of Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord. Amen. We're now going to sing Love Divine, All Loves Excelling.
In us thy humble dwelling, Lord, thy
Father God, what a glorious prospect awaits us to see you and at last to be made like you, filled to the measure of all the fullness of Christ, and for eternity to enjoy and marvel at your love for us in him. Please today continue your work in us by your Spirit, changing us, filling us, and using us to your glory. Amen. Amen. Thank you for joining us. God bless you.